Hello students, again I am here in front of you with objective type questions. Okay, so students, one thing, you all have watched my videos of power sharing chapter and notes are given in description. Study those notes. Those notes are covering your objective and subjective, every content. Okay, so now let's go for a recap as well as MCQ type questions. But firstly, let me explain you about two terms. Number one, civil war. What is civil war? Civil war is a condition in which two opposite groups are in conflict within the territory of a country, right? Civil war, जब एक कंट्री में ही टू कंफ्लिक्टिंग ग्रुप्स आर देयर एंड दे आर फाइटिंग एंड कंडीशंस आर नॉट ऑब्वियसली गुड. सो कंफ्लिक्टिंग कंडीशंस विद इन अ कंट्री, कीप दिस थिंग इन माइंड. व्हाट मेक्स इट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम अ वॉर इज इट इज विद इन अ कंट्री एंड वॉर इज बिटवीन कंट्रीज, राइट? तो दिस टर्म इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. Then majoritarianism, one term has been used. Let me explain you that. Majoritarianism is undemocratic rule, firstly I should tell you. Because this term reflects that rule of majority in whatsoever way they want. Means majority may disregard minority. But now, few would be thinking that in democracy also there is a majority rule. Those who are having the majority are ruling. But majoritarianism term is totally different from a democratic country's majority. How? In democracy, majority-owned government can't disregard minority. Okay? But majoritarianism is totally on the basis of this concept, we will rule the way we want. Means, can go for disregarding minority. That's why this term has been used in context of Sri Lanka and civil war also. So you are already aware of the condition. These two terms are very, very important in this chapter. Power sharing. Power sharing. So, which of the following is an example of horizontal power sharing? Number one, power sharing between different states. No, obviously. Then power sharing between different levels of government. It's called vertical power sharing, you know. Power sharing between different political parties. No, that's coalition government. So last is power sharing between different organs of government. If you remember in my video, I have told you that each and every body part, every organ of our body is equally important. You can't say eyes are more important than hands. Okay? So means horizontal power sharing. All the organs are equally important. Is it clear? Now, who elects the community government in Belgium? I specially told you in my video that one community, one language community will choose its community government, right? So people belonging to one language community only, means German speakers will choose German community government. French speakers will choose French community government. Is it clear? Now, the word ethnic, one more term is there actually, ethnic. Ethnic, and we have done ethnic composition of Belgium and Sri Lanka. Ethnic term means when we are sharing common culture, means our culture is same and obviously language is part of our culture, right? So, social division on shared culture is the definition of ethnic term. So they will try to confuse you by giving other options. So you just need to focus on shared culture. Then power sharing is spirit of democracy. Yes, keep this thing in mind. It is 100% true. Because if there will not be power sharing in any country, there will not be democracy. Okay, Then Sinhala was recognized as only official language by the Dash Act of 1956, you know. Okay, in that act there were three provisions. One was Sinhala was declared the only official language, obviously disregarding Tamil language. So a government for the entire country and but having different levels is called federal government. So in next chapter we have already covered it. So which city was chosen as the headquarter of the European Union? You already know, capital of Belgium, that is Brussels. Then after independence, Sri Lanka witnessed the supremacy of which community? You know, Sinhala. So under which act? Act of 1956. They said we will follow preferential policy. Okay, so they have, that's why they have went for executing Act of 1956. Then what is coalition government? Government of more than two political parties, as I suggested in first question also. Community government power may also be shared among different social groups. Okay, we have already discussed one language community will form one community government. Now name the countries with which Belgium shares its boundaries. A map is given in your book. So it is sharing its boundaries with France, that's why French speakers. Netherlands, that's why Dutch language. Germany, that's why German language. Okay, then what was Tamil Ilam? This term was used by Tamil speakers because they wanted to have an independent state in which they were in majority. Because they were not being accommodated by the Sinhala speakers and the majoritarian government. So they said, separate us. That's why they demanded Tamil Ilam, means independent country for Tamil speakers. Okay. So let's cover more questions. Choose the correct option. Question is, power sharing is desirable because it helps. A, to increase pressure on government, obviously no. To generate awareness among people, no. To increase percentage of voters, no. To reduce possibilities of conflict, yes. Why do we go for power sharing? So that there should not be conflict. Why class teacher is giving monitorship to different students? To reduce the possibilities of conflict and to encourage students to cooperate. Then system of checks and balances means horizontal distribution of power, separation of powers, federal division of powers, put a check on the exercise of unlimited powers of the organs of government by maintaining balance of power among various institutions. Obviously D is the right answer. Then community government is very significant feature and type of government in Belgium, right? So I hope you understood and this video will help you. Thank you so much. Keep watching, keep sharing and keep helping. God bless you.